Greetings. Welcome to our series of weekly devotionals. This week we are taking a look at some verses in chapter 2 of the letter of James. I remember a woman that had joined a church that I was pastor of many years ago. She was a new member, and the church was very small, so they were excited to see a new member, and she was a younger woman, so they were excited that a young person had actually joined the church, and she came to church for several months, and then all of a sudden she stopped coming, and she didn't come for a few weeks in a row, and I gave her a call, and I asked why, if something was wrong, why she wasn't coming to church anymore, and she said that she was struggling financially, and she just didn't have any money to put into the offering plate, and she was embarrassed, and so she stopped coming. And although I reasoned with her that that was no reason to stop coming to church, it didn't matter if you have anything to put into the offering plate or not. Still, she was not persuaded. And I can empathize with her because I remember when I first joined a UCC church many years ago, I was sort of in the same boat. I didn't have a lot of money, and you know, some weeks I would only throw a dollar or two in the offering plate, and I was embarrassed about it. I didn't really want anybody to know that I didn't really have a lot of money. And talking about money in church, it's always sort of rubbed me the wrong way. I grew up Catholic, and in the Catholic Church, my parents would get a letter from the diocese pretty much telling them, not asking, but telling them what they needed to give for the upcoming year. And that just sort of rubbed me the wrong way. And so I've always been not very good about talking about money, talking about stewardship in the church. In this passage in the letter of James, he writes, "Listen, my beloved brothers and sisters. Has not God chosen the poor in the world to be rich in faith and to be heirs of the kingdom that he has promised to those who love him? But you have dishonored the poor. Is it not the rich who oppress you? Is it not they who drag you into court? Is it not they who blaspheme the excellent name that was invoked over you?" Well, for the writer of the letter of James, at least, he or she has no problem talking about money. And this passage, I think, serves as an example to all Christians that regardless of our discomfort, we need to talk about money. We need to have conversations about money and the importance of money in our lives and what we do with our money. It's related to our Christian faith. You know, there's a saying that says, money talks. And in the church, that's true also. What we do with our money speaks about us. And I'm not just talking about the dollars we throw into the offering plate, but all of the decisions we make on a daily and weekly basis about money, how we spend it, how we prioritize it, what we do to earn our money, how generous we are with others. All of those things speak about our faith and what kind of Christians we truly are. I read a quote from the Reverend William Barber. He's the leader of sort of a renewal of the Poor People's Campaign, which was something that Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. started back in the 60s. And the Reverend Barber says this about our society as a whole, and perhaps more directly to the church. He says, "When the poor do well, we all do well." And I don't know if all Christians in all of our churches would necessarily agree with that sentiment, but I'm pretty sure that the writer of the letter of James would. Amen.